said there are long links, pre-independence, post-independence, and post-superannuation. Now tell me one incident which always flashes back in your mind when you sit and relax.
Well, this incident dates back to 1946 in Indonesia, Surabaya, northeast corner, where I was commanding a Punjabi Muslim army at the time, between of two Indian fleet company, now the senior was company of Pakistan. And we had a fair arrangement with the locals, because it's a Dutch country, and the British were using us to pull out place, but we knew that the British were going to leave India soon, because independence was looming and everything. And while we were working there, suddenly a crowd came out from a village. They had, some people had blown up a bridge, we were repairing it. And they said, they were shouting and this, and I was very angry, about 15, 20, 30 in Indonesian men, women, even some children. And I couldn't understand it, but my Lance Naik Sirajuddin Pathan, who had adopted me and used to look after me in all the troubled places. I said, ये कहते हैं कि कोई अंदर घुस के आए उनकी औरतों के पीछे जा रहा है। I got very angry. We only two Indians out of 27, so I got up, ran after them. I only had a 38 pistol, and I must have taken about 15-20 steps running after them with this mob going. When last night Saudi they shout from there, अच्छा, तू भी मरेगा, सानू भी मरवाएगा, and he did what I should have done. Put two light machine guns, we had four platoons, two light machine guns on the left, two light machine guns on the right, one light machine gun at the bridge side where we were working. He picked up a Sten gun himself, picked half a dozen men, put men around to watch. It was one platoon, all in sections, four sections, and we ran in and he came behind me with half a dozen men. And we ran into the village, and on the village there was a hut, and there on the steps was standing a sardar, the driver of this artillery truck. So I said, तू क्या कर रहा था इधर? मेरे सामने मुर्गी खरीदने आया था. So Lance Naik Sirajuddin got very angry. I'm boogie, झूठ बोल रहा है. And he fired two rounds in the air above his head and two in the ground. So this fellow came charging down the steps and lay flat on the ground. And when he lay flat on the ground, he fired a few bullets around him. And he said, तेरे चित्रा थे मार दिया गा. उठ के नट होते. The bridge was about 400 yards away. And this fellow got up and ran, and this Sirajuddin fired a few rounds in the air here and there and so on. The ammunition didn't come, there's a battle area, you see. And the whole village started laughing, which broke the tension. And I came back much, much wiser, learning that you are in charge of something. The job is done by a number of people. If you think you can do the whole job yourself, why have you got a number of people? Do it. You can't. So therefore, the quality of the work done is by each individual in whatever job he's doing. Your job is to supervise and make sure that you get the best out of it.
Best management principles, sir, which you have...
I learned it the hard way there.
Yes.
And it served me very well all my life. So you ask me, what is the lesson you learned? That yes. is the lesson.
Sir, my last question to you, sir.
You have seen many generations of Bombay Sappers, Indian Army, and your family is a illustrious family who have contributed a lot for the nation building. On the bicentenary celebration day, what message you like to give to the younger generation of Bombay Sappers?
Well, this is a lesson in life. While in school, I was interested in literature, and I read a verse called Mort de Arthur, meaning the death of King Arthur. It was a very famous, you know, in English literature at that time. This was English school, most of our, we were taught that sort of thing, 1930s. And it says, when he dies, he had the Knights of the Round Table, trouble started and so on. So ultimately, when he got wounded, he went off, and he went off to die, and then the people put him on a boat, they were going in there. And they said, what message do you have to give to us? And he answered and said, it's a verse written by Tennyson.
It said, the old order changeth and yieldeth place to new. And God fulfills himself in many ways. Now these two lines are quoted often, but the last line is seldom, says, and God fulfills himself in many ways of the word. And the last line is, lest one good thing should spoil the world. Now the lesson is, one good thing can spoil the world. That's what's happening in our country today. The extremists of, be it religion, be it belief, be it caste, be it any damn thing, be it money, the extremists, one good thing can spoil the world. So God's thinking of what is good has to go. Now, I've retired and I say this very clearly. The old order changes and yield a place to new. I'm gone. I'm going there as a bloody spectator. The new order must run Bombay Sappers. Sorry. With the changing times. Old guys like me say something, kick me in the ass. And older than me in Pune is Baba Bede, 1 year older than me. But he's a little disabled and not so well. I don't know whether he'll come or not. But he's 1 year older than me and lives in Pune. I hope he comes. Wonderful message, sir. I, from the side of, from on behalf of ADU, this is our portal, I would not like to say, Jeevema Sharadaha Shatam. You live for 100 years and all your organs should be functioning at that time. And you must be meditating.
My mind is
all the time.
Memories are gone blank, but if you trigger it like you've done today, then these things come back.
Yes.
If somebody asks me tomorrow, quote that verse for me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Here is Sangeeta, our editor. Sangeeta, bless you.
Thank you so much, sir.
She is also Bombay Sapphire.
I know.
She is more Bombay Sapphire than her husband, who got a unit citation on us during Kargil operations.
Excellent.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
The Kargil operation, that fellow lost a bit of his leg. He was an instructor at CAD just now.
PPC? No.
He was taking a section up the Kargil thing, he stepped on a mine, lost a bit of his thing. Paratrooper, and Bhakti, again, I'm sorry, I'm very glad. I know him so well. And he married some girl who's working in France, big man, earning much more than him, but they're very happy. He's an instructor at the CME now. And as he says, after I retired, I was invited to jump everywhere, so it's come up. One day we were doing a jump at the NDA, so in Kalapasla. So we parachuted and I landed very close to where the commandant was sitting there. So I landed, found two people waiting, took my parachute off me, everything else. Went and sat next to him and talked to him. And then suddenly this chap comes and lands right in front of them. He lands, takes off his shoe, and everything wraps it up. Then he takes off his boot, takes out something, puts on the boot again, and he had a padding there especially to for the landing straight. And he walks off with him. So he looks at it. I said, you know, he lost that bit of his heel in Kargil operations. I think it was 1999 or something.
99, sir.
Mm-hmm. He lost there. And they said, you'll never jump again. So a fellow lands up at Pune for a Bombay Sappers jump. My son said, what the hell are you doing? Aren't you banned? He said, shut up, sir. Shut up. Somebody might hear you. And he jumped and he kept jumping after that. And I said, now that is a real paratrooper and a real Bombay Sapper.
Spirit. Thank you, sir. Thank you.